All right. We're making a Carter bug. This is called spinning the deer hair around the spinning. One more small one. I like to tie a knot here before I cut. Quick knot. And we're going to trim the deer hair we don't need away. Try to get the body of the fly. Just got to watch out you don't cut your thread because we'll be using it again. My thread. I tied that knot in so I'll be able to fix it. I'm far from pro. Thank you. body of a fly. Put our thread back on since it broke. Cut that off. Supposed to be using a brown hackle, but I don't have any, so I'm using grizzly hackle, which is just long chicken neck feathers. So take one off here, take the end of it, and here, wrap it with some thread a few times, see if we can get it locked in tight. Now we wrap this, come around the body of the fly, right to the end, and take your thread. We're going to lock it in place so we come across it on an angle, trying to sink the thread into the body. Come back to the front. Cut off. Next fly. There's a tool for this, a whip finisher they call it, but I just use my fingers for now. Five knots at least. 2, 3, 4, 5. Tie it off. Snip. This isn't a pretty one, but it'll catch a fish. I've caught many a trout with this little fly. Well, if you're interested in how a fly is made, well, that's a very simple fly, but there's a general idea.